no fear, 'cause I believe there is no doubt. Good morning, everyone. Good morning.
Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning. Let's just Thanksgiving. Let's begin to give Jesus praise. Let's lift up the name of the Lord. Father, we just want to thank you this morning. Lord, we come in. Lord, you're a good, good God. There is none like unto you, God. Father, God, God, you are mighty in all your ways. You are good and you are powerful, God. None like unto you, mighty God. There is no one. There is no one like you, God. Father, I can say that. Oh, thank you, God, for your mercies. Oh, God Almighty, thank you, because there's none like unto you. We lift you up this morning, oh, God. We say, Lord, your faithfulness reaches to the heavens, oh, God Almighty. Your faithfulness is what is keeping all of us. We bless you this morning. Oh, Father, thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for being our dwelling place. Thank you, God Almighty, for being our power. Thank you, God, for being our stronghold, for being forever present help in the time of trouble. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we say there's none like unto you, God. We come in this morning and we say thank you. I just want you to thank him in your own words. Let's just lift up the name of the Lord. Let's give him praise. Faithful God. God is faithful. We have some testimonies here, you know, testimonies of jobs, of weddings and all that. God is doing great and mighty things. He's turning our prayer points into great testimonies. And that were children returning, things being turned around. So, Lord, this morning we just thank you. We give you praise. We worship. There's none like unto you. There is no one that compares to you, God. We just come in and we bless you this morning. We bless you, mighty God. We worship you, God Almighty. Thank you. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Words would never be enough to thank you, God. There's no way we can even recount all that you've done, oh God. There's so many things that you do that they go unnoticed, oh God. But this morning, we just come in and we say thank you so much. Almighty God, I bless you. Almighty God, we give you praise this morning. We come in, oh God Almighty, and we say thank you for daily bread. Thank you, God, for back, so God, counter my heart. Thank you, God Almighty, for delivering us from death. Thank you, God, for your daily benefits, so God. Thank you, God, for your word that is pure. Thank you for your word that is in truth. Thank you, God, for your saving grace, my Father. Thank you, God Almighty, for your compassion, oh God. Thank you, because you're dependable, Lord God Almighty. I know, and I know that many people on this platform this morning know that you are dependable, you are reliable, oh God. You don't go around like shooting shadows, oh God. You are constant in your ways, oh God. We thank you this morning. We bless you, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Let's go to Psalm 149. We're just going to praise God. As we are praising God this morning, I want you to have children in mind. And I want you to think of many things that the Lord has done for them. You know, as I said earlier on, God is releasing weddings, releasing spouses to our children. There was a beautiful, beautiful wedding over the weekend, you know. I'm in awe of God. I've been thanking the Lord, you know. God is just faithful. Also, testimonies of children getting jobs and all, you know, and lives being turned around by God. Lives are being turned around. So I just want us to come to Psalm 149. And it says, praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song. And his praise in the assembly of saints. Let Israel rejoice in their maker. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name with a dance. Let them sing praises to him with a timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people. He will beautify the humble with salvation. That's what God wants to do. God wants to pour out beauty upon our children, upon our homes, upon our dry places, you know, upon the troubled areas of our lives. God is turning things around and God is pouring out his beauty. It says, let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance on the nations and punishments on the peoples, to bind their kings with chains, fetters of iron, they execute on them the risk judgment. This honor of all his saints. I want us to just praise him. Praise him. Please let's unmute and praise God. Let's just go in with high praises today in the name of Jesus. It's a high praise for being that God. And it's
Thank you, Lord, thank you, Father, thank you, Holy Lord, thank you, Mighty God, thank you, Lord, 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 thank you, worst commander will give.
Mighty name, we have praised him. Let's go to Psalm 34. Psalm 34 says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked to him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried out, and the Lord heard. And saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamped all around those who delivers them. I want us to praise the Lord, bearing in mind that he will save us from all our fears and all our troubles. This morning, I want us to go in with confidence, knowing that there's nothing difficult for the Lord to do. He says, if you believe, all things are possible. In fact, the way I like to say to myself is that he has already delivered me from all my fears and all my troubles. In some areas, I may be waiting for the manifestation, but the work is done already, because we ride on the finished work of Calvary. So this morning, I want you to see the end from the beginning. The Bible says our God is the Alpha and the Omega. I want you to praise him, painting the end that you want to see in your mind. I want you to go in with the assurance that God cannot fail. It is not possible. We do not have a God who fails. No, it is absolutely impossible for God to fail. So I want us to go in this morning and really praise him. If you'd like to unmute yourself, go for it. Let's praise him together. Father, Lord, I just want to thank you this morning. I am the Lord. I want us to make a very bold declaration this morning that everything concerning our children will end in praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The things that are looking good now will not be thwarted in the name of Jesus Christ, so they will end in praise. The things that are looking very bad now will be turned to the Lord, and they will end in praise. I want us to come in with the power of agreement this morning and say, Lord, we agree that everything concerning all our children will end in praise. Remember that we are not so many on this platform. So if the enemy says, how can it all end in praise? You know what? We're just a handful. And our God is more than enough to meet everyone's need. So I want you to unmute yourself and agree with me that everything concerning our children will end in praise in Jesus' name. Father, Lord God Almighty,
Cover them when they were in our womb.
Jesus, I want us to come to Psalm 20. If you can open to it, because we're going to declare everything there over the lives of our children. Psalm 20. Let's go to Psalm 20. Thank you, Jesus. Faithful God. Let's just keep praising him while we're waiting for people to get there. Lord, I just bless you this morning, oh God. We just worship you. We give you praise, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. So Psalm 20, I'm sure most of us are there. So I'm reading from the Amplified Classic. It says, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. Whatever trouble has come to any child, we're saying, Lord, the Lord will answer them in the most appropriate way. If he needs to manifest himself to that child, he will. If he needs to go there, use his hand, and he will. Whatever the Lord deems fit will be done in Jesus' name. It says, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. May the name of the God of Jacob set you up on high and defend you. Send you help from the sanctuary and support, refresh and strengthen you from Zion. I want you to take those two verses and begin to declare them over your children. Let's go for it. Call the names of your children and say, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. We don't know when the day of trouble will come, but we know that God is the ever-present help in the time of trouble. And for children who are already in trouble, we are saying, Lord, arise today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Remember, oh God, your promises. And Lord, defend them, bring them out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Deliver them, oh God, because you are God and there's nothing that is difficult for you. Let's go for it. Father, Lord, I bring my children here, oh God, and every child that is presented here, the I bring my nephews, oh God, children. Oh God, the children, oh God,
I bring my children before the throne of grace this morning.
Revive our children according to your word, O God. Revive them according to your word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Revive our children, O God, according to your word, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want us to look at Psalm 119:133. I'm still going back to Psalm 20, but I just want us to go quickly to Psalm 119, verse 133. I'll read from 132. It says, look upon me and be merciful to me, as your custom is towards those who love your name. Direct my steps by your word, and let no iniquity have dominion over me. I want you to cry and say, Lord, look upon my children and be merciful to them, oh God, because this is your God who has loved your name. Lord, God, oh God, thank you, God, for the blessings of yesterday. God, ask for fresh birth, oh God, Father, upon us and upon my children, God, and be merciful to my and the cost of his Father, set them free, God, by the name of Jesus Christ. We cry for help, O God. They say, revive our children according to your word. Judgment, O God Almighty, in Jesus Christ. Father, look up, O God, and be merciful to them. Custom towards those who love your name and be accepted by you. But oh God, God, amen. Let's go back to Psalm 20. Psalm 20, verse 3 says, may he remember all your offerings and accept your burnt sacrifice. This morning, we're calling upon all the offerings. And I'm not talking only about money. You know, every good that we've ever done for anyone, towards anything, we're saying, Lord, remember those things, oh God. Remember those things, oh God. You know, even if those things, even if you did good to someone and they've repaid you with evil, the Bible says you will sow, you will reap what you sow, not necessarily where you sow. So this morning, I want you to cry out and say, Lord, remember the good things that I've done, oh God, and cause those things, oh God Almighty, to speak over my children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every good that God has enabled you to do for anyone towards any good cause, we're saying, Lord, remember them. He says, may he remember all your offerings and accept your burnt sacrifice. Those things that you gave from a place of pain, those things that you gave from a place of discomfort. You know, everything, even rising up early is a sacrifice of some sort, you know, because we're not rising up to do anything else, but just to declare his word over our children. That's why we rise up so early. And we've been doing it for over a year now, you know, going into 2 years or so. So I want us to, I think it's even over 2 years now, I'm not even sure. Anyway, let's just say, Lord, remember, oh God, to Lord, arise, oh God, and cause those things to speak over my children. And if you feel that you've done evil, say, Lord, have mercy. Let them not speak over my children. Father, Lord, God Almighty, this morning we come. Please unmute yourself and let's pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ and we say, Lord, remember all our offerings, oh God. Lord, God Almighty, remember, oh God, let the
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's look to let's go to verse 4. Verse 4 says, may he grant you according to your heart's desire and fulfill all your plans. The NLT says, may he grant you your heart's desires and make all your plans succeed. All the things that we're thinking of, all the good things that we're thinking of concerning our children, they will succeed in Jesus' name. I'm going to read verse 5 before we pray, and I'm going to read it from the NLT. It says, may we shout for joy when we hear of your victory. Amen. In Jesus' name. We will begin to shout for joy as we hear of the victories of our children in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, things will happen in their lives that will cause us to shout for joy. Things that will make the enemy tremble, but will make the godly rejoice in Jesus' name. It says, may we shout for joy when we hear of your victory and raise a victory banner in the name of our God. May the Lord answer all your prayers. That's why we can't even afford to pray carelessly. We can't pray now and then and undo our prayers, and then we can't pray for things we don't need. So I want you to say, Lord God Almighty, you know my heart's desires concerning my children. And you say, beyond that, oh God, let your own heart's desires, Jehovah, concerning my children come to pass. Let all your plans for them succeed in Jesus' name. If he's saying that he will make our own plans succeed, that means he has the capacity to make his own plans concerning our children to succeed. And he says, I know the thoughts that I have towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil, to give you a hope and an expected end. Another one said, I know the plans that I have towards you. I want you to cry out and say, Lord God Almighty, your heart's desires concerning my children, Lord God Almighty, let them come to pass, oh God. Let all your plans concerning my children succeed in Jesus' name. Do things in their lives, Jehovah, that will cause people to shout for joy. That will cause people, it says, may we shout for joy when we hear of your victory in the mighty name of Jesus. Please bless us. And you know what? Just pray over your children and say, Lord, let your hand be upon them, oh God, to do them your kind of good in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's unmute and go for it. Father, Lord, I just want to thank you for your word, oh God. I pray, oh God, that your heart's desires concerning our children, God.
Thank you, Father, for that which you have said, oh Lord, concerning them, because the thoughts that you have for them are thoughts of good and not of evil. Give them a future and a hope, oh Lord. I pray the name of Jesus, Lord, about the future, your favor. Every good thing you have purposed for them will manifest in their lives and in the name of Jesus. Lord, we want to enjoy the goodness of the Lord. They will enjoy the mercy of the Lord. They will enjoy your kindness, Lord. They will enjoy your favor, Lord. They will enjoy your blessings in the name of Jesus. And Lord, my God, I'm going to go to the hospital.
Afraid. I want us to just take a stop at Psalm 5 quickly. Let's go to Psalm 5, verse 4. It says, "For you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, nor shall evil dwell with you." We're going to say, Lord God Almighty, no wicked scheme of the enemy will come to pass in the lives of our children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Only things that will make us shout for joy and make even the onlookers shout for joy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And you know, I want us to be confident in our God, to say, you know what, it is the hand of the Lord that will bring it to pass. I want you to be bold in your spirit and say, Lord, by power in the name of Jesus Christ, no wicked scheme is coming to pass in the life of my child, in the life of my children, in the name of Jesus Christ. And there's no way the enemy will have the last say over their lives in Jesus' name. I want to it and say, Lord God Almighty, only things that will cause us to shout for joy in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, this is your word, oh God. Father, Lord, we've come again this morning to declare, oh God, that you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness. Please unmute, let's pray together if you want to. You are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, oh God. So, Lord, we come
and we Lord Almighty, no wicked scheme. Father, no wicked scheme. No man, no man of the devil, oh Lord, we come my children in the name of Jesus. No wicked plan of the enemy. No scheme of the enemy will come to pass in the life of my children. The enemy will not have anything in the life of my children. I do not give them anything in the life of my children. They do not have control and they do not have control over my children in the name of Jesus. I know that my God, the enemy doesn't have anything in the life of my children. The Lord Almighty has blessed me. My God, I have to see. The enemy doesn't have anything over the life of my children. I do not have anything over my children. I do not give them authority over the life of my children. I do not give them power. I do not give them authority over my children. My God, I pray. Amen. Thank you for praying. Let's go to verse 6 now. I'm still in Psalm 20. It says, "Now I know that the Lord saves his anointed. It will answer him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand." Verse 7 says, "Some trust in and boast of chariots and some of horses, but we will trust in and boast of the name of the Lord our God. They are bowed down and falling, but we are risen and stand upright." Then he says, "O Lord, give victory. Let the king answer us when we come." Now we're going to take those four verses together. I want you to open your mouth and declare that the anointing of the Lord will reside upon the lives of your children. The anointing that breaks every yoke. That the Lord will anoint them permanently, anoint them for good. That the anointing of the Lord will be a defense in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That no evil is allowed to come near them in Jesus' name. The Bible says when they went from nation to nation, from one people to the other,
He rebuked kings of the Assyrians, saying, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. This are all our children are rising up to be the prophets of the Almighty God, whether over their families, whether whatever, whether God will place them or just over their families or over hundreds or over thousands, none of them will be cast down in Jesus' name. And I want you to declare today that that anointing will bring them back from the land of the enemy if they've gone there. That anointing will keep them in God's sanctuary. That anointing will rewrite their story in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That anointing will seal them so that their good things will not be taken over by the enemy. And then I want us to boast in our God that is more than able. Father, Lord, we come in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And we declare, oh God, that by the reason of your anointing, every yoke is broken this morning. By the reason of the anointing, every good thing is protected in the name of Jesus Christ. By the reason of the anointing, every evil is exposed and destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. By the reason of the anointing, every good is shielded in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, God Almighty, shield our children's good things, oh God. Deliver them from evil, oh God Almighty. Father, Lord, raise up your hand, oh God Almighty, and let your power defend our children, oh God. Father, I bring my children to you one by one, and I bring every child that is represented on this platform this morning. I bring my nieces, my nephews, oh God. I bring the children of my friends far and near. I bring the children neighborhood, oh God. I bring the schools around me, Jehovah, and I say, Lord God Almighty, let there be an outpouring of your spirit over all of, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, fight for them from above, oh God. Arise, Jehovah. Let their enemies be scattered, oh God Almighty. Let evil counsels be scattered, oh God Almighty. Let evil decrees be scattered in the name of Jesus Christ. Let evil laws concerning scattered in Jesus' name. Let evil ideas, oh God, in their own minds be scattered in the name of Jesus Christ. Arise, Jehovah, oh God. Father, Lord, God Almighty, save them from above, oh God. Save them, oh God Almighty, with the saving strength of your right hand, oh Jehovah. Arise, oh God. Arise and defend them, oh God. Let the anointing be the difference, oh God. Let the anointing speak over them, oh God. Let your divine power set them upon and set them on high in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. I want us to go to verse 9. Verse 9 says, oh Lord, give victory. Remember, we had read in verse 5, that we will shout for joy when we hear of your victory. Now we are saying, oh Lord, give real victory, oh God. Let the king answer us when we call. And then before we pray that, I just want us to go to Psalm 44, verse 4. It says, you are my king, oh God. I've not come to a king who doesn't know baby, no. The Bible says, and the time came, and the king arose who did not know Joseph. That's not our portion. We have a king who is mindful of us, who knows us. My voice is not a strange voice in heaven. No, my cries are not strange to his ears. It says, you are my king, oh God. But who is this king we're talking about? Is the sovereign God. The Bible says he's the one who sits upon the circles of the earth. The Bible talks about your king and my king, that he has made heaven his throne and earth his footstool. The Bible says there's nothing that is hidden from him. The Bible says there's nothing difficult. The Bible says not a single word that he has spoken lacks power or fulfillment. That is your king. That is the one that is presiding over your matters. The faithful one, the loving king, the compassionate God. That is the God that we serve. We don't serve a wicked God. We don't serve an angry God. We don't serve a God who's not touched by the feelings of our infirmities. So now as we are going in, I just want you to understand who your God is. And I know we all do, but you know, just a fresh understanding of the Father that we are standing before this morning. So verse 4 says, you are my king, O God, command victories for Jacob. Command victories for each and every one of the children that we have brought today, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I want us to open our mouths and say, Lord, give victory, oh God. Give a command of victory over the lives of our children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Command their way to be prosperous, oh God. Command heaven to respond to them. Command earth to give up what is theirs in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Command the enemies to flee from them. Command their helpers to draw near to in the name of Jesus Christ. Command their eyes to open, oh God Almighty. Command their minds to shut down against things that are not of God. Give a command, oh God Almighty, and save our children. Don't only save them, set them on high, oh God. Don't only do that, oh God. Give them long life, oh God, to enjoy the beauty and the glory of your power in Jesus' name. Let's unmute and go for it. Father, we come in this morning, oh God, and we say, give it to our Jesus' name we have prayed. Please come with me to Psalm 37. Hallelujah to Jesus this morning. Psalm 37 verse 25 says, I have been young, now I'm old, yet I've not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his descendants begging bread. We're going to cry out. The Lord's Prayer says, ask, give us this day our daily bread. I want us to ask the Lord to give our children their daily bread of wisdom, daily bread of protection, daily bread of joy, daily bread of advancement, daily bread of health, you know. And before we pray, you know, because we are under a better covenant, I want us to look at what John 6:35. So this morning we're going to pray all the I ams of Jesus on our children. Amen. John 6:35 says, and Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. We're saying, Lord, be the bread of life to them every single day, in the mighty name, every single moment, in the name of Jesus Christ. And Jesus said, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. I want you to say, Lord God Almighty, even the psalmist said, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his descendants begging bread. Our children will not beg. They will not beg for the bread of promotion. They will not beg for the bread of advancement. They will not beg for the bread of long life and safety in Jesus' name. The Lord will hide them in the crucible of power. No weapon formed or fashioned against them will prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. And for those who have gone astray, the Lord will stretch his mighty hand and bring them. He will send the fishermen of heaven, the hunters of heaven. They will fish them out of every dirty water that they've gone to, and they will hunt them out of every dark place that the enemy has taken them to. So I want us to cry out and say, Lord God Almighty, they will not beg. They are believers. They are not beggars. Even if they are yet to know the Lord, because you're standing in the gap for them, they can only end up being believers in Jesus' name. They will not end up being beggars in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let us unmute and go for it. Father, Lord God Almighty, the word to you, God. Lord, in the Please come with me to John 8:12. Thank you, Jesus. And I'm going to read it from the Amplified. It says, one more, Jesus addressed the crowd and said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not be walking in the dark, but will have the light, which is life. The NLT says, Jesus spoke to the people once more and said, I am the light of the world. If you follow me, you won't have to walk in darkness, because you will have the light that leads to life in the mighty name of Jesus. That's why everything concerning them will end in praise. I want you to say, Lord, I raise you, Jesus Christ, I raise you as the light of life for my children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say, Lord, become that light, O God, unto them, so that they also become the light of the world in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And every path they take will lead to life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, we lift up your word, O God. Your word says that you are the light of the world. So, Lord God Almighty, I come in this morning and establish you as the light my children must follow in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Please unmute. Let's pray together. Lord God Almighty, we establish you. In Jesus' name, please, as we pray, I want us to be bold and establish Jesus as the life that they must follow, that the Lord God Almighty will compel their hearts to follow him. We are not giving them any choice. No, that not the life that they may follow, that they must follow, that the Lord himself will pull on the strings of their heart and cause them to follow him beyond our prayers, beyond the way our imagination. You know, it says he will do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. So this morning, I want you to say, Lord Jesus, I'm the one who's come to hand over my children to you. Wicked people will hand over their children to their idols. You know that sometimes the children would even get killed. Now we're handing our children over to our God for light and life in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, I am the one that has come to hand over this child, oh God, and to establish you as the light of his or her life, so that every path she takes will lead to life by the power in your name, Jesus. Let us declare it boldly. Father, Lord, we come this morning, oh God, and Lord, I'm the one bringing this one. Amen. Please come with me to John 10. I'm going to John 10, verse 9. John 10, verse 9 says, I am the door. Anyone who enters through me will be saved. They will come in and it will go out freely and it will find pasture. Then NLT says, I am the gate. Now, there are two things I want us to declare. Some children seem to be in a situation where everything is just shut against them. And it seems as if there's no way out. It seems as if the enemy has closed the door on their destinies and all that. But you know, he says, I am the door. So I want you to just picture a wall that has a door somewhere. And you know, now you've closed it and a door has been opened somewhere else. Because Jesus is the door. Wherever he moves to, there's a way out. We're saying, Lord, move in, oh God, and make a way for our children where there seems to be no way. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because it's the door, it can decide to create an opening anywhere for them to come out, for them to go in. In the name of Jesus, it says they will go out and they will come in and they will go in and out, and they will find pasture. It says they will go freely and they will find good pastures, you know. So God has made Jesus the door for us to go in and out, to get out of everything that is not of God and to go into the things that the Lord has prepared for us. And then daily to even go out and come back safely. It says you'll be blessed when you go out and when you come in, because your God is the door. And for difficult things of life, where it seems as if there is no way at all, today I want us to raise him as the door in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I just bring you in today, oh God, as the door for my children and every child that is represented here, oh God. Father, Lord, God Almighty, as your word says, oh God, let them go in, oh God. Let them enter in through you, oh God. Let them be saved, oh God. Let them come in and let them go freely and find good pasture in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, where there seems to be
way, oh God. Make a way for our children in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, where the door of health has been shut against them, become the door of health, oh God. Where hope is not, where they become hopeless, oh God, become the door of hope in the name of Jesus Christ. Where they have been deceived, oh God, become the light, become the door of truth in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we cry out this morning. We say nothing shuts in our children by the power in the name of Jesus Christ. My Lord and my God, Lord God Almighty, just arise, oh God, because you alone are the door. We command the wicked everlasting doors to be raised right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We command every door to be lifted right now in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are the gate, oh God. We confront every wicked gate this morning. We pull down, oh God, every wicked gate in the mighty name of Jesus, and we establish you, oh God, as the gate, oh God, as the door. You will keep the enemy out, oh God, and you'll keep the children in the place of safety, oh God. Father, Lord God Almighty, because you are the door, oh God, you'll be in charge of their going out and they're coming in Jesus' name. Father, when they're not supposed to go out, oh God, you shut the door, oh God. When you see that it's safe for them to go, oh God, you make a way, oh God, you open the door and they go in and out and they find good pastures in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, they will not go out, oh God Almighty, on the day, oh God, that wickedness is prowling the street, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, they will not stay in, oh God, on the day that the abundance is out there for them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we ask, oh God Almighty, that you take absolute control, oh God, of their movement, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let's go to John 10, 11. John 10, 11. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd sacrifices his life for his sheep. And we know that he has done already. And he says, I'm the good shepherd in John 10, 14. I know my own sheep and they know you. Now we are going to cry out and say, Lord God Almighty, shepherd them in the mighty name of Jesus. As we are crying out for that, I want us to just go quickly to Psalm 23. And we'll say what I'm trying to say. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Psalm 23, I'm going to read from the Amplified Classic. It says, the Lord is my shepherd to feed, guide, and shield me. I shall not lack. And if he says I'm the good shepherd, you know what? He's going to feed them, guide them, and shield them. They shall not lack in Jesus' name. I want you to cry out and say, Lord, I enthrone you in the lives of my children as the good shepherd to feed, to guide, and to shield them. They shall not lack. That is God's decree in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I establish God as the shepherd of the people. Hello, God, as the good shepherd, you have called yourself to shield and to guide them. Amen. Let's go to John 11, 25. John 11, 25. It says, Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Anyone who believes in me will live even after dying. Now they are still alive, okay? We're saying, Lord, where they need resurrection, Father, Lord, God Almighty, restore them, oh God. Let there be resurrection, oh God. Let them resurrect, O God Almighty, where the enemy has killed their lives, where the enemy has touched them, O God. We are saying, Lord God Almighty, bring them out of the pit in Jesus' name. And finally, when all the number of their days have been fulfilled, O God, let them not end up in the wrong place, because you are the resurrection and the life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you, God, for every child that needs resurrection. Father, Lord God Almighty, for every good thing that has been killed in the life of each child here, oh God. We see the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the grave, oh God, work in those situations in the mighty name of Jesus. Arise, oh God, and defend them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we stand, oh God, over
Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Almighty God, we pray, Father, because you are the resurrection and the life in the life of our children. Lord God, we pray, Father, make them believe in you, Lord God, I pray, and that you will resurrect everything that is dead, the lives of our children, spiritually, physically, in every area of their lives. Father, let it resurrect. Father, let it resurrect. Father, let it resurrect. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, I pray.
Before we go, John 15:5, it says, I am the vine and you are the branch. Those who remain in me will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. I want you to attach your children back to the vine in the name of Jesus and command fruits over their lives. We've run out of time. Let's do that quickly. As you are doing that, remember that it says, but if you remain in what remain in you, you may ask for it. You shall be. Father, Lord, we thank you, oh God. We establish you as a man of our children.
All the days of their lives in the
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for, oh God. Thank you, oh God, because you have heard our prayers, oh God. Thank you, because all promises are yea and amen. Thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful week. God be with you. Thank you for praying. Amen and amen.
Your faithfulness, my fortress, over and over. Make way through the